to explain the surface temperature of Earth is challenging. Okay, that is why greenhouse effect was introduced to explain some apparent discrepancy between the observation and the theory. But today, I'm going to propose a new explanation without invoking greenhouse effect. Okay, let's do it. Our Earth has been constantly illuminated or heated up by the sun. So the solar constant was introduced to describe the intensity of the sun, which is approximately 1,360, approximately. The unit is watt meters square. That intensity is before they penetrate our atmosphere. Due to the radiation, the surface temperature of Earth will increase. In order to balance, to keep the surface temperature as a constant, so our Earth actually re-emit certain amount of the solar energy absorbed. Our Earth actually radiate back some of energy back to the space. The issue is how to explain that balanced or equilibrium temperature of the Earth currently measured. To explain that, we have to go back to the 1900s. That year, Max Planck first explained the black body radiation. Black body is ideal model in thermodynamics. It was introduced in order to build the fundamental equation in theory. You cannot find any ideal object in the real world. Still, to some extent, many objects such as the sun and Earth can be approximately described as black body. So that is why the basic theory we are going to use today, originally obtained from the radiation theory of black body. In particular, the relevant law we are going to use is called the Stefan-Boltzmann law, which was empirical formula obtained before Max Planck. Okay, so of course now we can actually derive Stefan-Boltzmann law by the theory of the black body radiation proposed by Planck. The Stefan-Boltzmann law simply says if the black body has a surface temperature of T, it changes color. If the surface temperature of black body is T, then radiation intensity can be simply written as I equal to sigma. Sigma is constant, known as the Stefan-Boltzmann constant, times T to the power of 4. Quartic. Yeah. In order to specify this particular relation, I put the B here, B for black body. Okay. For many years that people have used black body to describe both the sun and the Earth in attempt to calculate the surface temperature theoretically. But unfortunately, as you can see here, there is always some apparent discrepancy. To be specific, the observed surface temperature is about 288 K for Kelvin, while the calculated temperature is only 255 K. Okay. So in this particular model, the discrepancy in temperature is 33 K. So it was big trouble, you know, in theory, similar to the trouble Max Planck originally encountered before he worked out his quantum theory about black body radiation. Because by definition, the black body is the object which can absorb completely the radiation from outside without any reflection. It also completely re-emit the absorbed energy. Okay, so that is by definition the black body. Of course, for Earth, this is far from the black body. So that is why people introduce what we call the Greybody. For the Greybody, and there is always some amount of the emitted, re-emitted radiation. But to compare with the black body, that amount of intensity can be significantly different from black body. So to do that, the emission coefficient, or sometimes they call the emissivity, used by a Greek name, epsilon, was introduced to describe the ratio of the Greybody intensity, radiation intensity, called G here, and divided by the intensity of black body. The epsilon is always between 0 and 1. So in this way, we can still apply Stefan Boltzmann law to describe the relation between the radiation intensity and the body temperature of the Greybody. So the intensity of Greybody can be written as, by definition, from this definition. Then if we substitute equation 1 into equation 2, if we just substitute equation into 1, then we can simply write this formula as epsilon sigma times the temperature to the power of 4. Here we have used equation 1, the Stefan-Boltzmann law. Although some researchers have been noticed this before, it would appear they didn't go further to fix another problem, which I just discovered recently. In order to explain the surface temperature of the Earth, a power balance question was introduced. So the power, by definition, were equal to the intensity multiply the area or the source of radiation. Or in this case, one is the sun, another is the Earth. This side, the reason why we use 4 pi r squared instead of the pi r squared, because we have assumed the absorbed solar energy by the Earth because of rotation, self-rotation, as well as the orbiting circular motion around the sun. So eventually, after many, many years, that distribution will be evenly distributed on the surface of Earth. Of course, by itself, that is approximation. This is a basic equation people have been used to calculate the surface temperature of Earth, but they have trouble. So this I on the right-hand side of the equation was written as sigma t squared, t to the power of 4. If you compare with this one, this is, whenever you see this expression, you know that that particular author has assumed our Earth is the ideal black body. Okay. And bear in mind that intensity of the sun, so the intensity of sun, by the time they penetrate from the sun, by the time they penetrate the atmosphere, will be significantly reduced. So in other words, the solar intensity I at the surface of Earth can be written as a product as a solar constant multiply a factor 1 minus alpha, where alpha is called albedo, and normally pick up the value is 0.3. That's to count the reflection by atmosphere, especially by cloud. Okay. Alpha is approximately equal to 0.3. That's just as a basic theoretical analysis, we just take this number. Okay. Of course, you can refine, you can obtain more accurate values if necessary. But here we are just trying to find basic relations among the variables. By using this power balance formula, we can obtain the theoretical value, which is apparently wrong because it is too low compared with the measured temperature. Okay. Now here is my new idea, how to explain this discrepancy. By the way, the 30K in many publications was called the greenhouse effect. It's called the greenhouse effect. Greenhouse effect. So in the context of studying the global warming, the greenhouse effect is not just an idea or a terminology. It's actually a number, okay? The additional thermal source, of course, I found it hard to, I don't think that is what I'm trying to promote. Actually, it is imaginary, okay? The greenhouse effect is imaginary, okay? Now the question is, without using this magical model, now how can I explain such apparent discrepancy? Let's draw your attention that if we just consider that our Earth is a Greybody instead of a Blackbody, then we can simply use this formula here. When we just rewrite this I into the epsilon here, we have this different color here. So we have this new formula. The intensity of the re-emission by Earth must be written as epsilon sigma t. Can we put a 2 here? T to 4 power. This is the new expression for the intensity of the Earth's re-emission. Okay. So this formula is actually equation 1. This comes from equation 1. So the difference is other people use treat the Earth as a black body, but I treat the Earth as a gray body. By doing some simple math, we can obtain the formula for epsilon can be written as the ratios of two values. So one is T1. Y is a T1, okay. Another is a T2. Another is T2, okay. To the power of 4. T1 is obtained by treating the Earth as the black body, and T2 is theoretically predicted by treating the Earth as a gray body, okay. Now, if we just assume that the T2 is exactly so equal to TS. That is, this is a equilibrium temperature of the Greybody. In this case, it's Earth. And this is experimented measured surface temperature of the Earth. So if you equalize that one, we've got these simple ratios. That's 255 divided by, we just rewrite this into the original form. That would be 288, okay? If just you use your calculator, you will obtain that this value is approximately equal to 0.61. So you can argue that the reason why the surface temperature as it is, that is because at present, the emissivity of the Earth, in this case, is around 0.61.